was a man who had a dream, a goal he had to gain. On the prairie of his soul, he planned a town that bears this name. Apache Wales, Apache Wales. From the Black Hills to the coast, it's the place that has the most. It's the rootin'est, tootin'est, shootin'est town that you ever saw.
I don't like the look of it, Jesse.
I don't know. I think it's rather pretty.
Would anyone care to tell me where it came from?
Hong Kong, by the look of it.
Did you know they have flamingos in Hong Kong?
The point is, what's it doing here?
Somebody's idea of a joke is that, Jesse.
Well, it won't be here when they get back. This is supposed to be Apache Wells. Not Tunbridge Wells.
For a minute, I thought it were Rod Holland, emu.
Some joker planted this down by the toilet block.
It'll be one of them Chesterfield Comancheros. Pretty colour.
Any jug-made coffee on the stove?
It'll be dinner in 10 minutes.
I bet I know which one it was, that ginger-haired one.
Why in?
Well, didn't you notice when he booked in, he had the biggest suitcase?
And?
Easily get a flamingo in that, he could.
Hello, Tom.
I was wondering,
Aye?
Has anybody handed in a plastic flamingo, by any chance?
A plastic flamingo, Tom? What colour was it?
Well, sort of pink.
Pink, eh? What size was it?
Well, it was about, that big.
Well, I haven't seen one quite as big as that, Tom. Could you remember where you last saw it?
Well, it was sort of planted in Rita's garden.
Whose garden?
Rita's.
A garden here?
Oh, didn't I mention it, Jesse?
No, Tom. No, you didn't.
Oh, well, I thought Rita'd like to have a go at making a nice little garden, keep her occupied.
Where?
Between our bunkhouse and toilet block. Just something simple.
Oh, simple?
Bit of grass, a few flowers, maybe a fish pond and a gazebo.
Oh. And what?
What's she want a gazebo for?
Some women like exotic animals.
Well, why doesn't she get a pair of them and let them breed?
A gazebo's a sort of old Greek summer house.
But, Tom, fish ponds and gazebos, I mean, it's just not authentic, is it? I mean, the one thing you and I prided ourselves on all the time we ran the Gunslingers back in Blackpool was authenticity.
Didn't know you was a member of the North Shore Gunslingers, Tom.
Oh, aye, 25 years, secretary and treasurer. I never missed a meeting.
Except for the 11th of January, 1972.
Oh, we're not bringing that up again, are we? I had flu.
Aye, so you said at the time.
I can't do with this here, love. You'll have to put it somewhere else.
Hey, you had it all the time.
Is it yours, then?
Aye, well, it's my Rita's for a garden.
The one she was going to make between their bunkhouse and the toilet block.
Oh, what a lovely idea.
Lovely idea?
Just what it needs.
She's talking about a fish pond and a gazebo in a western town.
Well, they had gardens in western towns, didn't they?
White picket fences and roses round the door.
Individually pruned by Olivia de Havilland. And clematis. They always had a clematis. That should do well up here. Semi-shade and plenty of well-rotted tea leaves.
Oh, yeah, the lovely clematis in Blackpool. Remember, Percy?
Now, Luke.
Well, I think it's an inspiration, Tom. I do, really.
They did not have plastic flamingos in the West.
They hadn't been invented then, had they, Jesse?
You shut up. All flaming gazebos. I am not compromising our ideals.
Well, Rita's going to do more than compromise me if she can't have a garden. My life won't be worth a hill of beans.
I've just remembered. Miss Witherstein had a very fancy garden in Riders of the Purple Sage. Tom Mix loved it.
Tom Mix, eh? Hey, you can't do better than that, Jesse.
Aye, well, we'll see if we can work something out. But it won't include that for a start.
All little gnomes or concrete bunny rabbits.
I've got them! We made the front page! Plus an inside spread! Look at front page! There's a picture of me! There is! Bank robber bites dust at Apache Wells. A spectacular fall by stuntman Bert Holroyd.
All right, Bert, all right, we can read.
Oh, look, there's a picture of me doing my presentation.
Oh, it's a nice one of our Betty handing the bouquet. Oh, she's right, you know. That dress does look cheap.
Proud, haven't they? It's worth hundreds in publicity, this, you know. Just you wait, I bet that phone never stops ringing.
Damn it!
What's wrong?
Well, just look at that picture of our Rita and Mayor.
Well, it's a good one of Rita.
A resident welcomes the Mayor to the unusual attractions of Apache Wells.
What's wrong with that?
They haven't mentioned her name!
Who is this speaking? Hello? Hello?
I wish I'd got some more copies. A spectacular fall by stuntman Bert Holroyd.
Hey, what's wrong, look?
Well, that phone call. I don't know whether it's someone's idea of a joke or what, but...
How do you mean?
This bloke called me a scarlet woman.
A what?
Garbed in the mantle of sin.
Sin?
And unless I repented, I would be damned for all eternity.
Must have got wrong number.
Sounds like my Uncle Davy. Always going on about scarlet women, he was.
You think it was him, then?
Oh, no. Oh, couldn't have been him. He never uses a telephone. Thinks it's the devil's plaything. Anyway, he's been dead for 10 years.
Don't look so worried, love. It's like Bert says, it's probably a wrong number.
Oh, no. This voice definitely said that Apache Wells was an abomination and would be destroyed.
Oh, isn't dinner ready yet?
Oh, ma'am.
I could have sworn it was 6 o'clock.
The evening meal will be served in 10 minutes. Perhaps you'd like to be seated?
My watch must be fast. Oh, the papers have come. Are we in?
I'll say. There's a lovely photograph of you.
Let me see. Let me see. Oh, that's nice. Me greeting the mayor. Here.
What's up?
I don't believe it.
What?
They miss my name off. Why'd they miss my name off?
Well, they're probably just short of space. But they're good, though, aren't they?
They've mentioned everybody else's name except mine.
Nobody can fail to recognise you for what you are.
Pardon?
Well, Mrs. Rita Henderson. Smashing photo.
I'll get copies of them all and have them framed. Well, some of them.
I don't know what's going on, but that was someone wanting to know what time the House of Joy opened tonight.
Who was it?
I didn't ask. Seemed to be having a problem with his breathing.
Hey, no, Eve, love. It's just someone having his own.
Well, I wish they'd stop it.
Do you think that you could ask Betty to lay dessert forks with our pudding spoons tonight? So much easier, I always find.
If it'll help you with your rice pudding.
How kind.
Rice pudding.
Well, should be about ready. Go and ring the gong, love.
Triangle.
Gong. They'll be here in a minute.
One less suit, Ma. Jim Turnbull's checked out.
You what?
About an hour ago. His wife's taken ill.
His wife? Jim Turnbull was married.
Still is.
Oh, Betty. Why didn't you tell me, love?
Personally, I were glad to see the back of him.
How can you say that about the son of a judge? The catch of the season.
Who wants to catch a prawn?
I thought you'd finally found Mr. Wright.
Mother, Your cheese sauce is burning.
You know, it's right thrown me out. My mind's gone a complete blank. Oh, I remember what I wanted to say.
What?
You got him to pay it for full week.
Of course.
Yes. I think that illustrates perfectly what we stuntmen call the reverse rollover with face down fall and final flip.
But what are the cardboard boxes for?
Company regulations, yes. Some of the less experienced stuntmen actually land on them.
Must you wear your hat at every meal, Thomas?
It's obligatory, love.
A true Westerner never takes his hat off for anything.
Anything?
Mind you, his spares are a different matter.
I was wondering why you never wear Western gear, Mrs. Henderson.
If I lived 6,000 miles away, I may consider it.
Calcutta?
Surely it's Iceland in that direction.
No, no, Tom, you've got it wrong. It's the middle of Africa down there.
Do you have to poke around your teeth after every meal, Thomas?
Best thing about store-bought teeth is they don't need no poking.
Worst thing is you can't eat solid food with them.
Hi, lad, that's true enough.
Well, excuse me, folks. I'm going to open up the bar.
Hey, excuse me. Hey, excuse me, but could you tell me what time Madam Zizi will be open?
What was it you wanted to know?
What time Madam Zizi opens?
There is no Madam Zizi.
You want that sitting down inside?
No, it wasn't.
They look like her with a photo in paper. What time do they open up then?
Who?
The House of Joy.
There is no House of Joy.
I've just come past it on my bike.
Vehicles are not allowed in the main street.
No, bikes aren't vehicles, they're bikes.
Now look, there is no Madam Zizi, there is no House of Joy.
But can I just wait outside in case they do open up?
No, you can't. Now look, Apache Wells is just a reconstruction of a town in the Old West, right?
Right.
And all those buildings there, they're just false fronts.
I see.
They're not real, but they have Western signs on them to make them look authentic. Like a film set. Get it?
Oh, hey, so you make them blue movies here, do you?
No, not make blue movies, pink ones and yellow ones. Now look, there's nothing here for you, so on your bike. Come on, there's a good
spot on the queue.
No!
Am I right for the House of Joy?
He's down there.
Just a minute. Just a minute. There are no cars allowed up here.
Hard luck. Is she open then?
He says there isn't any Madam Z's.
Rubbish. She's in paper.
Now look, you're on private property.
Who are you then? The Milky Bar Kid?
Where do I park for Madame Zizi's?
Right, that's it. Everybody out, now.
Just leave your car there. Oh, hello. He's got his cap gun out.
I reckon these folk need a little persuading to leave town.
Or perhaps be a guest at a little necktie party.
Hey, Lou. No offence. I mean, I saw this place in paper and I thought that
and
if
thought
I...
thought what, stranger?
I'll be going now. Isn't it nice to meet you?
Did you hear any of that?
No. What's going on?
Not what? Not two, but three men wanted to know when Madam Zizi's was going to open. One of them wanted to start a queue.
Strange, mighty strange.
How did they know about Madam Zizi's?
They said they'd seen it in the paper.
Oh, well, that's it, Jesse. If it's in the papers, everybody believes it.
If everybody who reads the Clarion turns up here tonight, we could have 17,500 people looking for Madam Zizi's.
You'll have to do something, Percy. That's my wife in there.
Well, I'm sure when they see her, they'll realise she's not what they're looking for.
What do you mean?
Pillar of virtuous respectability. I'm probably a bit too old.
Oh, now, Tom, calm down.
We can't tell Rita what's going on. She'll have an heart attack.
A barricade. That's what we want. Seal the town off.
Now you're talking, Jesse. Show them varmints we know how to protect our women.
Cyril, get to the end of the street and keep lookout. First sign of trouble, fire 3 shots.
I've only got 2 blanks left, Jesse.
Oh, 2 shots. Right. Now then, what we'll do is this. Okay. Loads of timber. Yeah. 6 inches.
Who do I fire them at?
In the air as a signal. Go on, go!
Right.
All right, men. Hang on here.
Good to see a bit of action at last.
Hee-hee! Now, don't panic, love. But we've had three men here looking for Madame Ziza. Yes, they said they've seen it in the papers and they think it's for real.
How does it explain those telephone calls?
We reckon there may be a few more on the way on the off chance, so we're going to barricade the main street to keep them out. Now, don't tell Rita about this. She'll panic. You know what she's like. I've worked out the perfect excuse.
Right, men! Tonight's activities are starting immediately. Would you please all grab a table and or chair so that we can demonstrate how the Western barricade was manned and fought to repel Indian attack? And don't forget, men, save your last bullet for the womenfolk. Follow me!
I don't like it, Jesse. It's too quiet.
Butch, keep your eyes skinned for strangers.
That's what they're skinned for, Jesse.
Did you hear anything, kid?
Pardon? Hello, Chris.
Not right now, kid.
There's a coach coming in.
Coming in?
Coming in. There's a coach coming in over there. Ooh, busload of them. Right there.
This is it, lads. No, no, keep calm. Keep calm. Take your positions. What are they doing now, Butch?
They're just sort of sitting there.
Maybe plucking up courage to ask for a party discount.
The door's sliding open. They all look like old age pensioners.
They gotta be the worst.
We can't keep old busloads of them at bay. We'll have to get some help.
One of them's getting out. He's looking this way.
Cyril, get down here, fast.
Yes, Jesse?
Now, look, son. There's not many I'd ask to do this, but someone has to ride for help.
And I'm the man for the job.
You're the one with the motorbike. Do you think we can get through?
I certainly try, Jesse. When shall I go?
Now, as fast as you can. And for goodness sake, keep quiet. Good luck, son.
Tense this evening. Are you all right?
Oh, yes, I'm all right. Your Tom was saying you were looking for a gazebo.
Oh, well, I was. They had a couple down the garden centre this afternoon.
Really? What was that?
Stick. One gazebo was lovely. Stone pillars, dome roof, genuine 19th century. It would have looked marvellous in front of that toilet block. They said they'd give me 5% off for cash, but I didn't have enough with me.
How much was it?
£18,000. I didn't fancy the other one, though. It was all plastic pipes and bent wire.
How much was that one?
£15.99, including that.
I think you're better off without one. There can be a lot of responsibility.
It's gone, Jesse.
What's gone?
The coach. Just as I was getting close, a man came out of the bushes.
Yes.
Got back on and he drove off.
No, it's a false alarm. Never mind. Better get on lookout again. They could start pouring in any minute now.
Right, Jesse.
I wonder how much longer that lot's going to be playing with their barricade.
Not much longer, I shouldn't think. They soon get bored.
Beats me how they all keep so keen. Thomas has never been interested in anything else since we were married.
It's a sort of disease, isn't it? A no known cure.
I once tried to get my Tom interested in breeding.
Must have been difficult.
Tropical fish. But it was no good. He still went off to the gunslingers every chance he got.
Understandable.
Pardon?
Nothing, is it my deal?
It's a bit of a trial at times, being married to a part-time cowboy.
It could have been worse.
Worse?
They could have been United supporters. You know, I think this has gone on long enough. It's nearly bedtime.
They'll play all night if we let them.
You give me 10 minutes, I'll have that lot back in here like lightning.
It's exciting, isn't it?
You know what, Jesse? I don't reckon anyone's going to come.
This could just be the lull before the storm. Keep those eyes peeled, Butch.
Peeled? And skinned, Jesse?
I think Bert's right.
Better not take any chances. We'll stay here till dawn, if necessary.
Daft as all staying out here. Can't we take turns and goes?
There's something coming, Jesse.
What is it, Butch?
It looks like... Yes, it is. It's a Cortina.
Now, just stay calm, everyone.
They've seen the barricade. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. I hope I'm not interrupting anything important. It's the mayor, Jesse.
He's the one who started all this. He'll be after my waiter.
Can we help you, Mr. Mayor?
It's just about that photo in Clarion.
Oh, which one exactly?
The one with Mrs. This gentleman's wife.
I told you!
Fact is, the Lady Mayor has pointed out that some people might suppose that I was given to frequenting such establishments.
Ooh, as Madame Zizi sees.
Precisely. So I have asked the editor, who happens to be a cousin of the wives, if he would put something in tomorrow, making everything clear.
It's agreeable by me, on one condition, that they mention Mrs. Henderson by name.
Oh, yes, yes, Mr. Rest assured on that.
Right, Mr. Mayor. We much appreciate you coming out all this way to tell us.
Oh, don't worry. We had to drive past on way home from the Rechabites pie supper. Can I make a suggestion? I should paint that sign over just in case. Goodbye, Tom. Oh, and do give my very kindest regards to Madame Zizi.
My wife's the one insulted, not him.
What the eye doesn't see, the heart doesn't grieve over.
But she has seen it!
But not cottoned on, lad. That's the point.
She will have her name in the paper tomorrow, Tom.
If that twit of a mayor can remember it.
I'll ring the editor first thing in the morning just to make sure it's done right. And that's a promise, Tom.
Great. So, can we pack this lot up then, Jesse?
Of course not. Not until the newspaper arrives tomorrow afternoon.
Come and get it, boys. There's sausages, beans, and jug-made coffee on the house. Bring your tables and chairs.
I hope you. Hang on. Don't all go at once. Well, we can do this in relays.
Oh.
Go on, kid. I can manage.
Oh, there's no way I could eat another thing, Jesse.
Thanks, kid. Happen the worst is over.
Aye. Still, no harm in playing for safety, Jesse.
In the morning, I'll get Bert to paint over the Madame Zizi sign. And young Cyril can do another one. He's good at lettering.
He's a good lad altogether, is Butch. Mustard keen on learning the quick draw. Best pupil I've ever had. Could be he'd take on the mantle one day.
Really? Mm. Is that good?
Oh, huh.
Percy, your chow's getting cold.
I'll have it out here, Tom, on the barricade.
Not much of a barricade left.
Enough to symbolise.
They shall not pass.
Exactly.
Well, if you're sure. Look, I'll bring you something out on a tray.
No, no. Your place is with Rita, Tom. How is she?
Oh, happy as Larry. She's just won 80p off Betty and £1.20 off your Isabel at cards.
Seems kind of ironic, doesn't it? We seal off the whole darn town so she can win a pile of money at the card table.
Just so she never finds out what's been going on. Be honest, kid. What do you reckon to this garden idea?
Well, Jesse, they do say a man's got to do what a man's got to do. But a woman will do what a woman wants to do, whether a man does what a woman does or not.
That's what you reckon, eh?
It's the way I see it. More or less.
Giving graceful.
Yeah.
A gazebo.
No.
A flamingo.
No.
A patio.
Righto.
Right. Patio it is. It looks like it's just you and me, kid. I'll take the first watch, and you can shut your eyes for a few minutes.
I'll shut them, but I won't be asleep, mind.
Good job I know how to fall.
Too true. Practice makes perfect.
Yeah. I finished, Jesse. Come and see. Looks smashing, it does.
Did you use the wording I told you?
Absolutely word for word.
That you ever saw.